Tonight, a 90th birthday tribute to Ronald Reagan. Joining us to share some very special stories, his wife Nancy, her memories, and a lot more. Next on Larry King Live.
Every year on this date, it seems like we've been doing it forever, we celebrate his birthday, he being the former President of the United States, Ronald Reagan. The birthday tonight is number 90, so we think it especially appropriate that instead of having a phone call, we would have her right here in the studios. The former First Lady, Nancy Reagan. What, did you ever think 90?
No, never. I still can't believe it.
90.
I know. It's incredible.
And he isn't the kind of guy that's supposed to be 90.
No, he isn't. Right? No, he isn't. Like Jack Kennedy. You can't think of Jack Kennedy as being...
Yeah, who would be? He would be close to Ronnie's age, right?
I think he'd be older, wouldn't he? Didn't
right.
I read that he'd be 100?
He'd be right there.
Yeah. You don't think of either one of them as being old. And Ronnie doesn't look it.
We never get to see him. How does he look?
He looks fine. I mean, the skin, he's got a full head of hair.
Would you say he does not look 90?
Oh, no. Mm-mm.
Is this genes?
It must be, because his brother had a full head of hair. His mother had a full head of hair. And Ronnie, I mean, when the barber comes to cut his hair, he has to thin it.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not.
And the color is still? Orangish-reddish?
No, it never was orangish reddish.
All right, what was the actual color?
Brown.
But a kind of brown that looked red in the sun. Looked red to me.
Well, I don't know what you were saying.
Brown, but he always had that light color hair.
Yeah, yeah. Got a few grays, but not many.
is there anything good about aging?
Well, if you find out, let me know, okay?
There have been better years for you than mm-hmm. this one, right? So let's discuss first, that was what's most immediate in the news, the hip. What happened? Because I know you fell. We had lunch one
yes.
day when you limped in.
That's right. Well, Ronnie got up out of bed and walked around and fell.
It was in the morning?
Mm-hmm.
Were you there?
No. I was at I'd gone to the eye doctor. And I was only gone for like 10 minutes.
So when you got
back? But there was a nurse there, not in the same room, but...
Was there a panic scene like when you got back, or...?
Well, the Secret Service called me to say that there had been an accident, and I got home, and, Larry, it was so incredible.
The pain?
Oh, well, Ronnie never, ever complains about pain, ever.
Wait a minute. No complaint with a broken hip?
No.
I am told that's impossible.
No. This time, when he was frowning and he was rubbing his right thigh, you knew he had to be in pain. Because he never...
Because me, I'm screaming, pounding on the floor. Give me something.
Yeah.
On the way home... You must have thought the worst, or did they tell you it was a fall?
They told me it was a fall.
Okay. The idea of getting someone like this to the hospital right away, here we have a former president. This is not your everyday patient. He also has Alzheimer's, which must complicate some of the kind of problems in communications. How was it done? How did it all happen?
Well, we called an ambulance and got him into the ambulance and went.
Why St. John's Hospital, which is not the one closest to you?
All of our doctors... We're at St. John's, and so that's where we went.
And what did they say? Is this is very common, right, in older people?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Was the prognosis good right away?
He was operated on the next morning, and Ronnie heals very quickly.
Because you're supposed to stay in 2 weeks at that age. That's what they said.
Yeah, well, he stayed a week. As a matter of fact, it was... 2 weeks ago yesterday that he had the surgery.
Yeah, we're taping this a few days before the birthday.
Yeah.
So they let him go home early because he was able to go
home. He was able to go home.
Now, does he have to walk with a cane?
Well, he hasn't walked yet.
When he walks, he will walk with a cane?
I don't know. This is all to be seen.
Were you able to watch? Now, you're the daughter of a doctor, and you've watched surgery.
Mm-hmm.
Did you watch this?
No. They wouldn't let me in the operating room. I was with him.
You have a lot of clout, Nancy. You could have said that one.
No, I wasn't in the operating room.
And how did he handle all of it? We always remember his grace during the shooting.
He handled this just as well. Just as well.
Did he know what was going on?
Well, he knew something had happened. Sure.
I mean, obviously. But, I mean, you know, we're learning so much about this disease. Was he comprehending what was going on?
I don't know, Larry.
The saddest part of all is we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But he wasn't screaming in pain.
Oh, no. He wouldn't scream in pain at all.
Now, at the same time, correct me if I'm wrong, Maureen is in the hospital.
Yes, we end up father and daughter in the same hospital.
You couldn't write this.
No, you couldn't. No, you couldn't.
How's she doing?
She's tolerating her treatments pretty well. And hopefully she's a very strong girl. And she'll be out.
They released a statement as melanoma, skin cancer?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Did you know this? Was she complaining?
No, no. She didn't know there was anything wrong until they found it.
And the treatment is what, chemotherapy?
Yes, the series of three treatments with 3 weeks in between each. And, you know.
You hope.
Mm-hmm.
She's a gutsy lady, though.
Yes, she is. Yes, she is. And I'm sure she'll be fine.
Maybe it's a blessing that her father doesn't have full comprehension, something like
that. Well, it was so strange to be in the hospital with her.
Did you go back and forth?
She couldn't come up to Ronnie.
Did you?
I went down.
You were a shuttle.
Yes. And Dennis, her husband, came to see Ronnie.
Now, what was the world? How was the world reacting to Ronald Reagan? Who did you hear from? Who was calling?
I heard from so many people. It was wonderful. It really was very heartwarming. I heard from, well, if we go for presidents, Ford, Bush, Senior and Junior. And then we get into Nakasone, Prince Charles.
How about well-wishers, everyday people?
Oh, lots. I mean, we got, I think, 10,000 emails at the library. Isn't that nice?
I want to talk about that library in a while, because that's very, very... I've been there, and I know how important a place that is. And we could maybe raise some money for it tonight. On his 90th birthday, that would be appropriate.
Yes, it would.
Because remember, we did an interview once on his 80th birthday,
mm-hmm.
where he promised to come back on his
yes.
90th. We're with the former First Lady of the United States, Nancy Reagan, as we celebrate Ronald Reagan's 90th birthday. Don't go away.
Hello, Larry, and good evening, President and Mrs. Reagan. Laura and I have now spent 2 weeks in the house where you lived for 8 years. Everywhere we look, we find reminders of the great men and women who lived here and the achievements they left behind. Your achievements, Mr. President, are clear to all Americans. They are found in the spirit of our nation and the peace of the world. You came here at a time when our country needed confidence. You told us we could be strong again at home and abroad. And when you left, we were. You came to the White House when the Cold War was real. You told us, even when few believed it, that the evil empire would pass and that freedom would prevail. And your resolve made it happen. In your time here, you never tried to seize the credit. One of the traits I have always admired most about you. But tonight, on your 90th birthday, America knows where the credit belongs. America knows you came here 20 years ago and changed the world. America knows the good heart that always guided you, the unbending principles that always defined you, and the kindness and courage and inner grace that makes you the man you are. For all that, your country thanks you, Mr. President. Your country honors you, and your country loves you. God bless you tonight.
If you're sitting in it, you're not looking at it. If you're looking at it, you're not sitting in it. Oh, the agony.
Flight 610 is now boarding. All passengers, please report to gate.
Isn't that our flight?
Yeah, I still have time to place a trade.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do. My discount broker is pretty amazing.
Who do you use?
My discount broker. There, my trade just went through, and it's already updated in my account. Updates instantly.
That's so.
Yeah, my discount broker is real time.
So what's their name?
My discount broker.
Look, are you gonna tell me or not?
MyDiscountBroker.com. Market volatility and volume may delay system access and trade execution.
He came to office when the American spirit was low, and through sheer personal charisma, became the country's symbol of hope, and in the process, becoming the image of the presidency. Beginning Sunday, the Reagan years, four special programs on the personal and political journey of the man and the legend. The Reagan years, 10 Eastern on CNN.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
So the hip now is mending, and the outlook is good for that, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The doctor's report. What did they do?
They put in a pin.
And then that fuses, mm-hmm. I guess, to the bone?
I guess so, Larry.
What were they like at the hospital?
Wonderful. Just wonderful. The doctor is great, and the nurses were wonderful. They were all nice.
Now, every time I called, you were there.
Oh, yeah.
Did you ever go home?
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
They brought you clothes?
Mm-hmm.
You are, in later life as you were in earlier life, you're a kind of inseparable, the two of you.
Yeah.
Can you explain that? I mean, we all know about love affairs, but yours is different. That book showed us how different, mm-hmm. the letters. Which I hope if you don't, I'm going to read a couple of times.
No, I'm not.
How do you explain that? Is this just fate? You and him?
I don't know. I don't know. I've had letters. I found a letter that was written to me from a girl who was getting married. And she wanted to know the secret of a happy marriage. I said, and I wrote back and said something to the effect that I had no magic formula, and I never sat down and thought about it. But everything just fell into place with Ronnie and me. We completed each other.
Did you ever fight?
We disagreed, but we never yelled or slammed
never
doors.
Never had none of those, get out of here.
No. Mm-mm. But there's nobody that you agree with all the time.
So you, by completing each other, words, where you weren't whole, he made you whole.
Mm-hmm.
And you the same
mm-hmm.
for him.
Mm-hmm.
And that continues now.
Oh, yes.
Except you are faced with something now, and you've helped so many people by getting the tragic way that someone has to have affected by someone for us to be focused on it. When did you first notice?
I didn't.
You never noticed the Alzheimer's coming on?
No. No. We went to Mayo's in August that year.
Was there the normal memory slippages that older people have?
Well, yes.
You know, I forgot his name.
You forget names. I forget names.
Forgot we had lunch today.
So, no, I didn't notice anything.
And then what happened at Mayo?
Well, they diagnosed it as Alzheimer's.
And they came and told you?
Mm-hmm.
Did you get second opinions? How do you react to something like that?
Well, we've been going to Mayo's for so long, and I knew all the doctors so well. I accepted what they said. But, of course, nobody can ever know what it's like till you're there.
This is the 90th birthday of former President Ronald Reagan, and we're saluting him tonight with a visit with his wife, the former First Lady, Nancy. We'll be right back.
Larry, thank you for giving me this opportunity to join Ronald Reagan's many friends in wishing him a happy 90th birthday. My particular warm regards go to Nancy Reagan, what courage she has shown over the years. And let me say to my dear friend, from whom I learned so much, President Ronald Reagan, we will never forget your kindness to the Bush family. I will never forget the principles of leadership that I learned from being at your side for those 8 years when you served so nobly as President of the United States of America. God bless you. God bless you at 90 years old.
Will you travel down this road with me? Help me be the one I want to be. Help me see the things I long.
Internet helps you reach millions of customers around the globe. But who's keeping you in touch with the Internet?
Fujitsu. The possibilities are infinite.
Her mission was to seek out signs of intelligent life on Earth. What she found, no one could have ever imagined.
What is it?
People no one knew existed until now.
We are out of the future.
From the star of My Potato Chip Pantsuit and I'll Be a Monkey's Uncle comes the true story of the first urban explorer. Jeannie Moos is making the most of it. Now showing on CNN tonight, three times a week at 10 on a TV tuned to CNN near you.
Log on to CNN.com.
It's the world at your fingertips.
Everything you need to know whenever you want it.
It's easy.
Indulge in fine fashion.
Or maybe pinstripes and stock quotes are more your style.
CNN.com.
Get cooking with gourmet food tips.
Go inside the game, no matter what your game is. Rain or shine, five-day forecasts from Albuquerque to Zanzibar.
From around the world to your desktop.
Wherever you are, it's all at CNN.com.
What was it like for him to write that letter, that now famous, what was it, 94?
94, he went into the library, and I was with him, and he just sat down at the table and wrote it.
Now, we have learned subsequently through letters how good a writer he was.
Oh, yes. Very good writer.
I wonder if he doctored scripts ever, because he could have.
No.
He had a way with words.
Yes, he did. But there's a book that's coming out by Marty Anderson called Reagan in His Own Words. He found a lot of speeches and radio shows. And
he wrote his own radio show?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Oh, and that's I saw somewhere that's coming.
Yes, and it's wonderful. I mean, you can't believe the things that he wrote about. I remember when he first ran for governor and people criticized him because he was talking too much about foreign affairs. And then when he ran for president, they were criticizing him for the opposite. I mean, you know.
He liked to write.
He liked to write, yes.
So he just sat down and wrote that letter to the public.
Mm-hmm.
Because he knew what was coming. So, as they say, what Hemingway says, class is grace under pressure.
Yeah.
He had that.
He sure had.
Did he express fears to you?
No.
He didn't say,
no,
this is going to be terrible, or
no, well, all he said, which is in the letter, that he knew it would be hard on me and that he hoped that with people's support and faith that I'd get through. And he was sorry to put me in this position.
What should people know who hear this news about a relative, a wife, a husband, a mother, a father? What advice can the caregiver give another caregiver?
Well, that's hard to answer, Larry. You just get up each day and put one foot in front of the other and go. You know, each day is different.
But it is.
It's a progressive disease.
That's right. So Monday is not going to be better than Sunday.
Mm-mm.
What about new drugs we hear about?
As I understand it, they have two new drugs that will delay the onset, which I would have been very happy to have used.
But toughest part for the caregiver, I guess, is you don't get back what you give.
Mm.
Right? Isn't that the hardest, to keep giving when someone is not responding, not through any fault of their own?
No, that doesn't bother you. At least it doesn't bother me. It's sad to see somebody you love and have been married for so long, and you can't share memories. That's the sad part.
You know, I never thought of that. Couples sit down and say, remember when little Fergie broke his foot?
Right.
There was the picnic.
Right, right. You can't do that.
So you share them with yourself. How important are your friends?
Oh, very important. Very important. But, you know, you don't want to, if somebody calls you, you don't want to unload on them every time they call.
You're not a complainer by nature, right? You don't sit around and talk
I
about
hope
it.
Not.
But you have, you know, helped a lot of people.
I hope so.
You've raised a lot of money
for
this disease.
Yeah.
For a while, you weren't talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
What made you change?
I guess being with Ronnie.
And I guess he would have wanted you to,
mm-hmm.
wouldn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Because he would have wanted
That's
to help.
That's why he wrote the letter, because he wanted to help people. And he made it public, and, you know, the same thing that he did with colon cancer, prostate cancer.
He's had them all.
He's had them all.
On the occasion of his 90th birthday, our guest is Nancy Reagan, his wife. We'll be right back.
Hillary, Chelsea, and I are proud to join all Americans in wishing President Reagan a happy 90th birthday. Our thoughts and our prayers are with him, Nancy, and their family. This is an occasion for us to reflect on the great contributions he made to America, the enormous spirit and sense of optimism, the constant faith in the future of our country that he brought to every day on the job, indeed to every day of his life. So on this day, we say to you, Mr. President, and to you, Nancy, we thank you. We thank you now for 90 years of the American dream.
If the value of your home has risen during the last couple of years, now may be a great time to refinance and cash out some of your equity. Just log on to ditech.com or call us at 1-800-71-FIX. Today's low fixed rate is only 6.750%, APR 6.916% with 0 points. And there are no upfront fees. It's smart money from ditech.com. Apply online or call us now at 1-800-71-FIX.
I told my father I wanted to grow up to be a teacher. Wouldn't you rather be a doctor? He said. It's a noble profession and you could become wealthy. That may be true, I said. But without teachers, where would doctors come from?
I think why Crossfire works is you get two opinionated hosts, you get two expert opinionated guests.
I want a guest who believes in what he or she is saying.
You get a hot topic, you pour them all into 1/2 hour, and then you just sit back and see what happens.
The things we talk about are things that really matter in America.
The great thing about Crossfire is you know you're going to hear and see all sides of the issue.
Crossfire, 7:30 Eastern on CNN.
What do you do with frustration? Because you must have that. It must be frustrating when you're with someone who's not cognitive.
Well, you just learn to live with it. I mean, what is there to do?
Well, some people, there are hospitals that specialize in just treating Alzheimer's patients. You would never do that.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Never. Never. No, no. He's going to stay at home.
Do you ever hope that maybe the end comes? I mean, do you ever say, You know, that maybe it isn't such a life.
No, I never.
Because he's not in pain.
No, he's not in pain.
How goes the library, by the way?
Very well.
People come every day. They come more when there's a news story.
Well, there were a lot of people who went to the library after he broke
his
hip.
That's what I mean. If the name comes back in the news and...
Yeah, and I mean, they were lined up bringing flowers and everything.
Would you describe the setting? I've been there. Describe, first of all, where it is.
It's in Simi Valley, California.
His favorite view there, right?
Yeah. The shining city on the hill that he often talked about. It's high, and you have a wonderful view, which he always liked.
And there's a lot of great things in that library, including a whole film career.
Well, you know, when you think about it, he's had an incredible life. When you think back, I mean, sports announcer, pictures, governor, president, it's incredible.
He's a large mirror of the society.
Mm-hmm.
He even gets a disease at the end of his life that becomes one of the prevalent talked about diseases.
Yeah, yeah.
He has the most prominent men's disease that we all feel, prostate. That's old news to him, right? Mm-hmm. That was history long ago.
Yes.
Prostate, the cancer was yesterday to
that's
him, right? So he's pulled through all this. Mm-hmm. His wife has breast cancer.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, what are there any aftermaths of that for you?
No.
Are you in good health?
Yes, knock on wood.
I mean, you're okay because you are frail. Not frail, you're not Zoftik, you know what I mean? You walk quietly in the room.
Well, thank you, Larry.
Are you in good health?
Yeah, I think so.
Do you still go to Mayo for your checkups?
No, I haven't been since Ronnie and I were there together. I should go, but I don't want to leave him.
Now, you don't have visitors, do you?
No.
Because you don't want people to see it?
I don't think that Ronnie would want that. I think Ronnie would want people to remember him as he was.
So when you read a newspaper or watch television, do you still talk to him? In other words, do you have discussions?
Well, no, you can't.
Because there'd be no response at all. I don't know how you do it.
You get up each day.
You do it because you do it.
Yeah.
Has the library added new things?
We keep changing the exhibits, you know, because...
And you still have those great group of speakers. I was honored to be one.
Mm-hmm.
It was a great day.
Yes, it was.
It's a great presidential library.
It really is.
Whoever put it together. And it needs funds all the time, right? This
of
is
self-supporting. Of course it does. Of course it does.
We'll be right back with the former First Lady of the United States right after this.
Ron, congratulations on your 90th birthday anniversary. We join your countless friends worldwide in complimenting you on a fabulous public career for many, many years. You were an outstanding governor of the state of California, and you did a superb job as president of the United States during the very difficult days of the Cold War with the Soviet Union. You have our very, very warmest best wishes in the years ahead from Betty and Jerry Ford.
CNN viewer Arnold Rodriguez from the United Arab Emirates asks CNN, why exactly are Israel and Palestine in conflict?
Arnold, that's a good question, and the answer depends on which side you ask. The Israelis say the Palestinians started this latest outbreak of violence as a way to pressure Israel into more concessions in the ongoing peace process. The Palestinians say they are fighting to end the Israeli occupation and for the right of self-determination in their future homeland. One thing is certain, this fighting took many people by surprise. Just 6 months ago, the two sides seemed very close to a peace agreement. It could be that closeness which led to the fighting. They had gotten down to the core issues for a final peace. Those issues are the makeup of a future Palestinian state, the fate of Palestinian refugees, security arrangements, and of course the most hotly contested issue of all, the future of Jerusalem, specifically who controls what in this holy city. Discussions on these issues and other past differences open deep-seated passions among the Israeli and Palestinian people. However, it could be argued, as opposed to fighting over the past, they are really fighting for the future. Whatever compromises they make today to reach a peace agreement will have a big impact on the Israelis and Palestinians as they live together in the future, side by side as neighbors. The Israelis and Palestinians are likely to continue fighting one way or another until they reach what they think is the best deal possible for the future of their people.
Ask CNN is brought to you by Sir Speedy Printing Copying Digital Network. For outstanding document solution and the center near you, visit sirspeedy.com.
Business.
E-business.
Sir Speedy Printing.
SirSpeedy.com.
Face-to-face.
Online interface.
Personal.
Productive.
Local.
Global.
Very human.
Very modern.
Easy.
Easy.
Sir Speedy.
Either way.
Sunday on The Reagan Years, The Making of a President. Sunday, 10 Eastern on CNN.
Where can you see Bruce, Michelle, Pierce, and Nicholas and get a great bonus? Only on Showtime Unlimited, with 10 channels for only $10.99. Call now to order the latest Hollywood movies and more. You'll get 6 channels of Showtime and 2 of the movie channel, plus 2 bonus channels, Flix and Sundance Channel. It's a great value. 10 channels for only $10.99. Call and order Showtime Unlimited now.
Join us for the next Charlie Chat, Monday, February the 12th at 9 p.m. Eastern on Channel 101.
The Moneyline News Hour, weeknight 6:30 Eastern on CNN.
In time the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may tumble, they're only made of clay, but our love is here.
I want you to comment on something. This broke last week. That former President Ronald Reagan, whose friends bought him a $2.5 million home in Bel Air in 1989, paid those friends back with interest after he left the White House, his chief of staff said last week, with all the stories about gifts and the like. We had never known that.
Well, at the time, it was public.
The gift was public, but I never knew.
Did we repay?
Yeah.
Well, you know, some things are just left out of stories.
So it was always a loan then?
Always. Always. Our money was in a blind trust, and we had to buy a house, and we didn't know how much money we had. So the friends bought it, and then we repaid them with interest.
Without willing to put any discomfort on anyone else, do you think you got a bad rap on gifts?
A little bit.
Well, you wrote about it in your own book. Uh-huh. I mean, you took a lot of hits for things that are now every day. Mm-hmm. You ever feel funny when you see things like that?
A little.
So it was always the intent to pay back the house, and the house
always
is paid back with interest.
With interest.
I'll bet you most people thought that that was a lifetime gift.
They probably did, just as most people think, I bought the china.
They still think.
I still read it. I still hear it. And I keep saying, it was donated. It was donated.
All you did was borrow some dresses for designers, right? That which is done
all the time.
The wife does it when she goes to an event. Designers like to do this. I want to discuss some things because we're going to be showing some clips from them, and I want your thoughts on them. When you sang Our Love Is Here to Stay, that White House gala, what was that moment like?
Well, that's our song, you know.
Gershwin to you.
Mm-hmm. And I sang it to Ronnie.
Did he know you were going to do it?
No. He was so surprised.
We have just seen an inaugural. I guess one of the inaugurals, there's some inaugurals that remain implanted in our minds. Certainly John F. Kennedy's in the snow. And your inaugural, the red hat. the red coat, mm-hmm. looking up. What do you remember?
I remember mostly that it was very overcast, gray. But when Ronnie came forward, the clouds broke and the sun came out. Same thing happened in Sacramento.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
On his first term as governor?
Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, when he was shot, the next morning there was a rainbow over the White House.
What were you thinking then? Were you then the girl who grew up in Silver Spring, or the little girl from Chicago? What were you standing up there? Your husband is about to become president.
Well,
you made movies together.
Yeah, well, we just made one together, but...
Hellcats of the Navy.
Yes. Well, it's so overwhelming when you're really doing it that I don't remember thinking anything except that, my gosh, here he is, and he's president.
My Ronnie.
My Ronnie.
He just celebrated the anniversary of Challenger, and we will never forget your husband that day.
I know.
What was that like for you?
Well, about like it was for everybody else.
You went down there.
Yeah, yeah. Terrible, terrible. Sad.
Is that one of the hardest things of executive things that people have to do? Tragedy.
Oh, I think so, yeah. Trying to give people support and, yes, it's very hard. And they're crying, and you're crying, which I can do pretty easily.
How about his farewell speech? He said goodbye. Is that a sad day for you, or are you happy to leave? You did a little spin around the Washington.
Yeah, we did. The helicopter took us over the White House, and he looked down and he said, "Look, honey, there's our little cottage."
We're with the former First Lady of the United States, Nancy Reagan, as we celebrate Ronald Reagan's 90th birthday. Don't go away.
Well, I want to express my heartfelt congratulations to President Ronald Reagan on his 90th birthday, and also my best wishes to his wonderful wife.
Are you paying attention to me? For 10 years, you've waited for his return.
I have been in a state of hibernation, but now I'm back home, very healthy.
This Friday, the wait is over.
Are you ready?
We could have some fun.
Good evening.
Dr. Lecter.
Hannibal.
See you around.
Rated R starts Friday.
Karen Ellis invests in three different mutual funds so she can relax, knowing she's diversified. What she doesn't know is that her funds have 40% of the same stocks in common. See how we earn it. Solomon Smith Barney.
November 23rd, 1998. America's major tobacco company signed an agreement that restricts the marketing of tobacco products. No more billboards, and no more cartoon characters selling cigarettes. The tobacco industry says things are changing, just not their deadly addictive product.
Dale, I understand you have a statement.
Yes, I do. Just because I'm presbyopic doesn't mean I can't see what's going on. I say let's get out of the dark ages and give me and the 100 million other presbyopes the visual freedom we deserve.
Dale, this revolutionary new patented lens from Verilux may be just what the doctor ordered. It lets you see near, far, and everything in between.
Foot fault.
Assassination attempt. You were out that day, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where were you?
I was at a luncheon at an art museum. And for some reason, this has never happened to me before or since, and I hope it doesn't, I just had this overwhelming desire to get out and go home. And I did.
Here we go again.
Yeah.
No call?
No. And I went back to the White House, and I went up to the...
Left early.
I left early, yeah. Didn't stay for dessert or whatever. And I went up to the solarium, where they were doing some work, and then George Opfer, who was head of my detail, came there and said...
And what does he say?
He said, there's been a shooting, but don't worry, the president's all right. And he thought he was. Everybody thought he was.
And he said, told us, he didn't know he was shot.
That's right. That's right.
And then what? Right to the hospital?
Right to the... George kept saying, you don't have to go. He's all right. He hasn't been hurt. I said, George, I'm going. You better get the car because I'm going. And I went.
What days those were. We I guess then, as we didn't know about the house, we didn't know how close we came to losing him.
Oh, yes.
That was touch and go.
Yes, it was. I almost lost him.
Did you know that?
Yes.
In other words, they didn't Pollyanna it for
Mm-mm,
you.
No. The nurse would come in periodically and give me updates. Then I remember one time she said, well, we may have to leave the bullet in there. And I said, leave it in? I don't think that sounds very good. And they finally found it, an inch from his heart.
Was there a time, truthfully, where you thought you'd lose him?
Oh, yes. Yes, there was.
You know, Nancy, as you look at the totality of your life, the totality of it, your father, you have breast cancer, you lose a mother shortly thereafter, mm-hmm. Your husband has all the disease, he gets shot, he's attained everything and had every misfortune. How do you regard yourself? I mean, are you lucky, unlucky?
I don't really think about myself that much. I really don't.
Do you know, some people go around and say, boy, the gods, they give me this and they take it away.
I must say, the last couple of weeks, I felt like that little cartoon figure who walked around with a black cloud over his
little
head.
Abner.
Yeah, little Abner.
The thing around his head.
Yeah.
Or as Al Pacino said in Godfather 3, every time I drive that thing, draw me back in. Do you ever feel that fate treated you badly?
No. No, when you balance it all out, I've had a pretty fabulous life.
You ever miss acting? You almost took a role.
Yes, I did.
If Ronnie weren't sick, you were going to do Mother for Albert Brooks,
That's
right?
That's right, I was. And it would have been fun, maybe.
What was it like at that tribute to you at the convention?
Very sweet, darling.
What's it like seeing your old friends there? Colin Powell, Secretary of State, one of your favorite people on earth. Your husband wanted him to be president.
Uh-huh, yeah. I'm very happy he's there.
Do you think about endings? Do you think about... I know, because I stood there with you. You know where you're going to be buried.
Yeah.
Hey, that's weird to me. but you know exactly the place
Most presidents do know.
It's either at the library or the site they choose. Mm-hmm. So you every time you go to the library, you look at that.
Well, I don't really look at it. I just know where it is.
Do you think about?
No.
Ronnie could make 100 then, couldn't he?
Sure, could.
Everything else is fine.
Everything else.
Heart, liver, lungs, kidney.
Yep. Yep.
Appetite still good?
Yes, not as
he had
good
a great
as
appetite.
It was. Yes, he did.
I had lunch with him once. He destroyed the desserts.
Yeah.
Still like desserts?
Yes, but not, you know, he doesn't have as big an appetite as he used to. But he eats.
I'm going to spend a few more moments with Nancy Reagan on this occasion, the 90th birthday of her husband. Don't go away.
Reagan, you know, was always underestimated. Everybody thought somebody wrote speeches for him and then he gave them and that was it. Reagan basically wrote every speech he ever gave. George Shultz tells a wonderful story about handing the president a speech that George Shultz was going to give one day when he was Secretary of State. A week or so later, he came back in and asked the president if he'd had a chance to look at it. And the president said, sure, and handed it back to him and said, it's a good speech. Then he added, but I wouldn't give it. And George said, what do you mean? He said, well, you know, he said, I write speeches for the ear, and these are speeches for the page, for the word. And so the two of them sat down, and Reagan rewrote the speech for George. Happy birthday, Mr. President.
Walgreens is pleased to announce millions of new locations. Your homes. Presenting Walgreens.com. Now you can join millions of users who manage their health care on America's healthiest website. Just think, all of this under one, well, make that millions of rules. Register online or come into Walgreens Pharmacy and we'll do it for you. Walgreens.com. Another reason Walgreens is the pharmacy America trusts.
The internet helps you reach millions of customers around the globe. But who's keeping you in touch with the internet?
Fujitsu, the possibilities are infinite.
Wednesday on Larry King Live, Attorney General John Ashcroft's breaking his silence. It's the first time since his nomination made headlines and sparked a bitter political battle over his beliefs. It's a Larry King exclusive Wednesday, 9 Eastern on CNN.
I think it's all too common in marriages that no matter how much partners love each other, they don't thank each other enough. And I suppose I don't thank Nancy enough for all that she does for me. So Nancy, in front of all your friends here today, let me say thank you for all you do. Thank you for your love. And thank you for just being you.
We're back with some more moments with a national treasure, Nancy Reagan.
Took a lot of,
I remember those first 2 years. I forget. Mm-hmm. What goes around comes around, though, doesn't
That's
it?
What they say.
Either way. What led to the publication of the letters book? Because we didn't get a chance to talk to you in that book. We did a whole show reading those letters, and you must have cried that night.
Oh, I did. Marvel. Yes, I did. Well, you know.
Merv Griffin reading letters. Mm-hmm. How did it come about?
Well, I had all these letters. I mean, I saved letters from before we were married. I saved Christmas cards. No. I know, Ronnie.
Oh, but before, I mean, if you save, you save.
No, I don't. No. Life began with Ronnie. I came to realize that I had to make some decision about these letters. And I could destroy them, which I couldn't possibly do. Or I could leave them where they were, but then you run the risk of somebody finding them and selling them. So the library was a perfect place.
And the library benefits from the sale of them, right?
Alzheimer's and the library. It was split. I didn't get anything, but
people want to help the library, by the way. It's just the Ronald Reagan Library in Simi Valley, California. And is there one Alzheimer's fund that you're associated with most, or is it the National Alzheimer's Fund?
National Fund in Chicago.
I'll just read one of the letters. I know it's hard for you to read them. As dear First Lady, so you've already got the job. As President of the United States, it's my honor and privilege to cite you for service above and beyond the call of duty in that you have made one man, me, the most happy man in the world for 29 years. Beginning in 1951, Nancy Davis, seeing the plight of a lonely man who didn't know how lonely he really was, determined to rescue him from a completely empty life, refusing to be rebuffed by a certain amount of stupidity on his part, she ignored his somewhat slow response. With patience and tenderness, she gradually brought the light of understanding to his darkened, obtuse mind, and he discovered the joy of loving someone with all his heart. Nancy Davis then went on to bring him happiness for the next 29 years as Nancy Davis Reagan, for which he has received and will continue to receive his undying devotion forever and ever. She has done this in spite of the fact that he still can't find the words to tell her how lost he would be without her. He sits in the Oval Office from which he can see, if he scrooches down, her window and feels warm all over just knowing she is there. The above is the statement of the man who benefited from her act of heroism. The below is his signature, Ronald Reagan, President of the United States. P.S. I love and adore you.
Yeah.
Why didn't we know how well he could write while he, you know, he should have written more.
He didn't have time when he was president.
I know,
every speech, he went over and he would change a lot of it.
So that image we had of him was just reading what they gave him.
Oh, no. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. That's not so. As this Marty Anderson's book points out.
And that book will be called what again?
Reagan,
in his own words?
In his own words.
Yeah, I think it's just come out. I think
the February 6th, yeah.
New York Times just reviewed it. Scheduled published today because this is the day.
Uh-huh.
Nancy, I really thank you for this visit. I know you don't do a lot of these things.
No, I don't.
I really appreciate it as a friend. And, well, you'll come back on his 100th.
All right.
Anything you want to say?
Just, no, thank you, Larry. Nice to see you.
Anything to people?
No, I love all the people who sent us all the messages. And
they never forget, do they?
No, no. If anything, it grows, which is nice.
Does it ever bother you when he's spoken of in the past tense? Because we haven't seen him in so many years, you know that it's easy. Even senators say, presidents say, he was.
Yeah, yeah.
Does it bother you or do you understand it?
Well, I'd rather they didn't do it, you know, but I understand.
For whatever it matters, give him our best.
I will.
And to you.
Thank you, Larry.
Nancy Reagan on her husband's 90th birthday.
Internet IP.
Internet protocol IP.
Let me tell you something. There is no protocol.
The internet is one big mess.
And you know why? No love.
Where there's no love, there's no harmony.
Till these cats at Broadwing built the world's first all-optical network.
Not with their brains, man.
But with their heart.
And some freaky engineer mojo.
No, no.
This is not an IP network. This
is their love child, man.
Today, enough coal to power one out of every nine homes in the country travels on the BNSF railway. Music by Mozart. Electricity by the people and the coal trains of BNSF.
CNN adds another perspective to financial news.
The Moneyline NewsHour puts the day's financial news into perspective for you.
That's our key priority, remembering what the investing public wants to hear and wants to know.
We'll unearth the facts and we'll make sense of them all.
No jargon, no statistics. Get away from all of that. Let's give you the big picture so that you can understand where your money is going and what it's going to do for you.
The new Moneyline weeknights on CNN.
Happy birthday, Ronnie. I know with Nancy by your side, she'll give you all the love in the world and make it the best you possibly can have. I love you, and I love you, Nancy.
One cannot do a birthday tribute to Ronald Reagan without having his good friend Merv Griffin on. He joins us from Los Angeles. So good to see you, Merv. What were you?
Thank you, Larry.
Were you very worried?
Opportunity for being able to come on and wish the president a happy birthday. I was with him on many of his birthday parties, the festive ones.
I guess you were very worried when he went to the hospital.
Very, very. But he's so strong, you know, he can recover. He's a fast mender. But you know, there's nothing he liked better on his birthdays than those very festive parties with the people he enjoyed and was comfortable around, even during the presidency. But can I tell you about one party where he was the star like I have never seen? There was a man here who was very well-to-do. He had homes in Paris and out here, and he gave a big party for the Reagans. We all went. But he had a lot of the French there who had flown over for the party. And it was a great night. The man giving the party didn't speak English too well, so he said, Merv, his name was Al Madani, would you be me? And I said, oh, okay. So I got up and spoke in Arabic. No, I didn't. But I got up and I spoke, and I welcomed everybody, and I said, this is a very great joining at a party for the French and the Americans. And I said, I know someone in this room who would like to get up and sing the Marseillaise. Well, everybody applauded, and I said, ladies and gentlemen, President Ronald Reagan. Well, everybody gasped because no president has ever sung the Marseillaise that I know of. And he got up and sang every single word perfectly in French. Lynn Renault was there. She jumped up from the table, ran in the other room, and called Jacques Chirac on the phone and said, President Reagan has just sung the Marseillaise! But he had won another war, you know?
Hey, Merv,
he is great.
How do you explain, as Nancy tried to discuss it, this enduring relationship between those two?
I guess it it just happens in life. Two people who just adore each other, who were great friends, I'm sure great lovers, a great marriage, and she was there by his side, and they just worked beautifully together. Yeah. And that's...
And they had it right from the start, right? You know them a long time.
Right from the start. Unbelievable. They both have a great sense of humor. I mean, amazing sense of humor.
Merv, how do you explain his incredible hold on the public? Now, he hasn't been seen, hasn't spoken to us in 7 years.
Yeah, I think they remember him as one of the great leaders, a father image, which America has always loved, because their brother image got into a little trouble. Their father image, looking into that camera and talking in everybody's language and being very honest about what he was saying. He was one of the people, and yet he was a great leader.
Did you expect it from him? I know you're close friends, but did you expect him to be the kind of president he was?
Isn't that funny? You never think of that. I never sat down and said, will he be a great president? I just knew that everybody who was around him admired him, and we knew he could translate that through the tube and into people's homes. And if his, you know, what we all heard is Reaganomics, and the press all laughed at him with his Reaganomics, they called it. Reaganomics worked.
Nancy said that Ronald Reagan, she doesn't want people to come see him because he wouldn't want people to see him as he is now.
That's absolutely right. I have never asked, and nor would I, to see him. He wrote me a letter. He wrote a number of us right after his letter to the American public, and he wrote us and told us what we had meant in his and Nancy's life. Yeah. And to me, that was it. I think it would be too difficult to handle.
Thanks, Merv, as always.
Thank you.
Merv Griffin, one of our favorite people, entertainer, entrepreneur, and a lifetime friend of the Reagans. That completes this special 90th birthday edition of Larry King Live. We thank our guests, the former presidents as well, for their participation. Stay tuned for CNN Tonight with Bill Hemmer, and happy 90th, Mr. President. Good night.